Good morning, and here I am again at in the Formula Rookie US Championship Round 3 Sonoma Raceway Short, a really cool track with quite a big elevation gain. The short version, which I don't think I've ever actually raced on. I raced on the long version in LMP2. I think it was a 3 hours long race in Project Cars 1. Let's go and race, practice, qualifying. End the race, 8 laps, difficulty 95 and 100. This is a starting point where I then may adjust it. I had it 95 for the previous race, which was on Watkins Glen. It was also short version, and to be honest, I was losing badly in the first laps. And what saved me was the weather. It started to rain, and I was significantly faster in the rain than AI. What are my tires? Slicks. It's a nice weather, so we're going to stay on slicks. So let's start. Let's do some practice. To put my gloves on. Whoa. Which I forgot about.
So remember, take it easy on these tires and get some heat into them. Don't push too hard too early.
for a mate. Hope he's okay. Much about pushing that one guy. This is just a practice. In a race, I probably would restart. I would feel bad, even though it's AI. I like to be fair. I like to drive fair. It's important to learn a good behavior with AI, so then you can drive cleanly during the multiplayer races when. You don't want to crash into other players. Especially in pre-organized races like a leagues, where everyone spends time practicing. You don't want to destroy someone else's race. First, 125.572. first sector was significantly faster than the last time. The second sector was slower. Cancelled. Did I cancel the box? This is PlayStation 5. But the game, of course, is for PlayStation 4. Hasn't been improved to suit the PlayStation 5 capabilities. Though I think it has more FPS generally, runs a little better on PS5 than PS4. So, what's the difference? The difference is huge. 1.3 seconds, so I think I'll be increasing the difficulty for the qualification. Okay, I won't be... You're most welcome. I won't be continuing that session, there's no point. Skip to the qual. Let's do the qualifying. I'm going to exit to increase the difficulty. It was 95 for now. I think I'm going to crank it up a little bit. They're usually faster in qualification, so I don't want to go too high. I'll try 98. I was also overheating the engine. So I may look into increasing the cooling. It doesn't really matter for an 8 laps race. It's not enough time to destroy the engine. But let's just open that radiator to maybe 80. Okay, and let's try to do the qualification. Guy crossed the yellow line coming out of pit. Should be a warning at least. Doing. of a clean way for the flying lap. So I just really wanted to overtake him. I was first for a moment, but it wasn't a great time. Faster this time. Third, so at least two drivers were faster than me so far, but I should improve on this lap. Everything goes well in the final sector. And I have a little bit of slipstream as well. And I'm back to first. 24.5. That's my fastest lap so far. Between practice and qualification so far. As I'm first, I'll be going to pit.
Check confirm, we got that, we'll go.
This guy was too close for me to improve the time. I had to race with him rather than focus on improving the time. Hit that pit limiter in time. Where's my pit stop? Why they were not waiting for me? Oh, it's here. So let's see the times. I'm still 1 second faster, even though I increased the difficulty. I'm going to increase it again for a race. Okay, we're going to skip to end. Maybe they're going to improve, maybe not. We'll see. they haven't improved, so let's continue to race. Here, let's exit. What's the weather? Clear, lovely, it'll be really hot. So I increased from 95 to 98. Achieve 5 pole position qualifying in courage and look at the emission limit. Perfect. I will increase it to 104, another plus 3. And let's see how it goes now. I had a 3 second gap between me and the second after the first lap. It's pretty pointless to race like that. I mean, I'm sure a driver in real life would be happy to have a gap like that after lap one, but it's not real life, right? Again, we want some challenge. Starting this in the clutch, I just find it faster than getting the gear, the first gear on the green light. So that's difficulty 104. Let's see how they'll do. They're already staying behind. So much faster than me. Here at 104 in dry, they cannot keep up. I had that difficulty issue in Project Cars 1, where in Le Mans 24 hour, and I actually did the whole 24 hours racing, I had that difficulty in LMP2 class, I had that difficulty at the maximum, and I was still a few seconds quicker per lap. For such a long race, that's really bad. You're not really racing anymore, you're just lapping bike markers from the lower classes, GT4 and GT3. Then you have to be careful with the LMP1s, which are just so much faster. But there is no battle in LMP2, and there wasn't a battle in LMP2. So I had like 10 laps advantage at the after race. It was crazy.
Two times so far today, mate. Great job.
And in other races, like Road America, LMP2 as well, a 6 hour race, I think. I had to lower difficulty for some time. 5. So it varies truck by truck. Also, in Project Cars 1, AI was usually faster in the wet conditions than the player, and here it's the other way around. As soon as the rain starts falling from the sky, and the stronger it is, the easier it is to win with them. Yeah, that looks quite sweet. This gap stays around 3 seconds. At least I can relax a little bit and comment. The engine, it's good that I opened the radiator, it's quite warm. 46 degrees to truck temperature, 30 to the ambient. The water temperature is at 99, so that's it's ideal, isn't it? It was overheating during the qualification because the radiator was too close. The radiator at 80% is perfect.
Nice one, a new PB.
25, 1 minute 25.162. It's, I think, 0.6 seconds slower than in qualification.
Good job, your fastest in
second sector so far. Great job, keep it up. Oh, that will ask me to slow down. Yeah, okay, I can do that. Matteo Stirati is from my teammate.
That's your fastest lap in the race so far.
24.678, that's very close to my qualification time. Someone had an accident. I'm closing by to a back marker. 16 seconds, it's going really quick. Oh, I looked at the time and I lost focus. That guy in the pit? Yeah, I think it's here on the left hand side. Had to be an accident. He was just lapped. That's lap 7 out of 8. So we're almost there. Mm-hmm. quite safe gap to second. So as long as there won't be any mistakes, I should have that win. Track. Zonoma Raceway is such a good track. The elevation changes are amazing. The blind turns. Americans have some really nice racetracks. Watkins Glen, Road America, Zonoma. Laguna Seca, of course, the corkscrew, the famous corkscrew. Really like to race in the American Championships. Not necessarily open wheels, but I want the accolades. But once I move to the endurance racing and GT3, GT4 racing, oh, that will be glorious. But I'm leaving the best for last. I want to get rid of the open wheel first, because that's my least favorite class. Okay, it's a nice win. So I was increasing the difficulty 3 times over the course of this race weekend. Practice 95, then I increased to 98 for qualifications, as they were quite slow. They were still slow, so I started the race for the first time at 101. I was still too slow. I increased it to 104, and it was still a bit slow. I could have been quicker to provide for a better challenge, but you know, I cannot restart those races who knows how many times, so I just kept 104. Oh, that's the guy who had an accident. Oh, he lost the wheel. No, that's not mine. Where's mine then? Why is no one waiting for me? Going for another one. Great. I won't be doing that. Okay, so it's 1-2 for our team. That's perfect. And I also have the fastest lap. And we have a nice advantage as a team in that race. Okay, I'm building the advantage for the last race, so that should be an easy championship win. And we should get that team championship as well. Car was actually overheating in the last stage of that race. 5 degrees water temp. Should have opened that radiator even more. Okay. Ah, that's the classic shutdown. Showdown. Okay, so what's the race for? Texas Motor Speedway infield course. Doesn't look too interesting. It's one of the oval tracks with a chicane. Not a big fan of this, but needs to be done. Now, I'm going to reduce the difficulty, as I always do. That's my starting point. Practice and see how it goes. I will be adjusting accordingly for qualification and then for a race. Yeah, let's start.
We need you to get some heat to these tires on the outlap and start pushing.
I have never raced here before, so I'm not really sure what to expect in terms of braking points or even turn speeds, you know, how to negotiate them. I completely missed this one in the apex. It's the chicane, I guess. AI will be super fast here. They're usually much faster in those fast chicanes than I am. At least on dry. Attacking, I'll let him go. I'm still learning the track. And he's using it here. Okay, let's race then. Ah, you have inside, you go. Super short truck. It's also super fast. I guess slipstream will play a huge role in that race. Wrong. Slowly learning the truck. Getting grip of it. But I have to say I don't like this truck, so I praised I praised American racetracks on my previous race because they really have some good racetracks there in the US. This one is not one of them. This one is boring, flat. It's boring turns. I'm first, okay, so... Looks like I learned what this track had me to learn. I'll do a few more laps just to practice a bit more. It's the last race of the US Championship anyway. And my point advantage is big enough not to worry too much about this particular race. But yes, the slipstream will definitely play a role in that race. Like, what's the point of the chicane if you don't even have to brake, you're just going flat out? Same here. Maybe it poses more of a challenge for a faster cars, but then again, the track seems to be too short for a faster cars. And don't get me wrong, I understand the need for ovals, for example, and I understand that, you know, many Europeans think that NASCAR is just driving in circles. It's not. It's very difficult to drive at those speeds with those heavy cars, bumper to bumper. NASCAR is more than just turning left, and they also race more traditional tracks like Circuits of the Americas and stuff. Even in rain, like last year, it was quite an interesting race. Okay, that'll be... Roger, wrong button. That'll be enough. The entry right here? It is. So how does it look like? Okay, that's not a big difference. They will be faster in the qualifying, so they probably will get a better times. It depends if I can get a good slipstream in qualifying to elevate myself to a higher position. Okay, let's move to qualifying. So skip to end. My teammate is second again. That's really nice. That should, if we could finish on high position, that should solidify our win as a team. Medium cloud, so no rain. Okay, let's go to the qualifying. We don't want to get any penalty for speeding.
Warm this thing up and see what you can do.
It takes some time to warm up those tires. They're really cold at the moment. But the truck has this... Oh my gosh, that's the hottest I've ever seen. So the ambient is 33. But the truck is 63 degrees. 63 degrees Celsius. You go outside if you want. Does he have a speed? Oh, he bumped with me. Okay, you wanna go too wide? You can go too wide. I'm happy with that. Oh, that's nice, man. I told you that AI will be quicker in qualifying. It's a short track, so it's very, very crowded. Left front finally got some temp, 71 degrees, so it's good. The other three are still a bit cold. And I'm heavy, I have 90 liters of fuel. For these cars, it's a lot. It burns only 0.35 liter per lap. So I'm assuming it will be 10 lapper, so 4 liters of fuel should last the whole race. Okay, I'll let him go. My tires are warm up, so I'll be trying to get some slipstream now. Coming out of the last corner. At the moment I'm lost. Last, even though I improved by half a second and I caught up the guy in front of me. I think I have to burn more fuel. Now we're going faster this time. Looks like I'll be starting from the back of the field. Oh, I was tight. Unfortunately, I went out. Next one as well, okay. I'm curious what's the lap difference, the gap between me and 11th and the first as well. Not too worried though, because I know that they will be slower in the race. That's how the Project Cars 2 works. It's significantly faster in qualification. And as I can understand that with a more sophisticated cars, heavier cars, more aero-dependent cars, where you can really change a lot. I don't really understand it that much with those Formula Rookie cars. lot slower here. Oh, I use the fuel to try to improve. The tires are still in good condition. So I lost a lot in the sector 2. I guess that was due to that chicane. I was going too much over these curves. Let's see now. Improved, and I'm 8th. So a small improvement gave me 4 positions. We can improve it further, I know we can, because the car still has a lot of fuel, it's heavy. And I should gain a few more positions before the end of that session. Not on this lap though. Too slow already. Maybe on this one.
What is that? Boxes left.
I'm going to keep the P8. It will mean more interesting race, having to fight for positions. There we go. The gaps are really small. So, let's stick to it. Skip to end, go straight to the race. And looks like my teammate didn't do well. 11 or 12, because I don't see him in the first 10 of us. Okay, continue to race 1. Now that car was burning 0.35. This is 12 lapper, so 3.5, a bit more than 4 lap. So 5 liters will be enough for the whole of the race. So half of what I have at the moment. Here we go. 5 liters, safe. Okay, start the race.
Focus on the light. Let's try and make up some ground
clutch.
Off the line. Keep it clean.
So, clutch, first gear. Guard the lights. Let's see the lights. Not a bad start. I like to start from the clutch rather than. Rather than just upshifting to 1, the first gear. Oh, that's close, wheel to wheel. I hope AI won't do anything stupid. I was closing that inside, I had to slow down. I don't have to be first to win the championship, already have a good advantage of points. Rather take it slowly, or maybe safely, not slowly. Be fast, but be safe. Too wide, oh, too wide. bump into me. I had to slow down because they were slowing down in front of me.
Second sector, that's the best time so far. Nice work.
That's because I'm pissed off. AI is crazy.
Nice one, the new PB.
A little touch, nothing dramatic. But I had to use the speed I gained that she came. Wow, that was crazy. I was braking, I just didn't have time to brake. As soon as I saw them braking, I also started braking. I wanted to avoid it at all costs, but there was nothing I could do. I'm sorry for that guy, I hope he lives. But that chicane, you always drive at full throttle. And I don't know why they were braking there. That happened second time in the race. This is just the implementation of the AI for it. I mean, sometimes I'm grateful that they brake because, you know, you can overtake them, but that was way too much braking applied by them. I didn't get a warning from the race director for dangerous driving, so I take it that the game decided it wasn't my fault, and I don't feel it was my fault. And the way that car really exploded into the air was a bit funny as well. I think I will save the replay just to see it from a different angle. We have one more lap. I'm fourth. I started eighth. So that's our fourth position gain. cannot complain.
Final lap. We need this third place. Come on, you've got to find a way past this.
We have our championship already. Being on a podium would be a bonus. Then maybe we will be in a podium. Yeah, I think I'll take the third. Nice. Are they going for one more? I don't know why they went for one extra lap.
Lovely job, nice driving.
But I won't do it. Guy, I hope it was my teammate. Where's my teammate? Ah, here he goes. He's eighth. Okay. So I'm third point wise. Yeah, I'm first. 4 podiums, 3 wins, and the team is first as well. Perfect. That's US Championship Formula Rookie. US Championship done. That means I got all the accolades for the Formula Rookie, and I can move on to Tier 5 of Open Wheel. Continue. Well, I'll be skipping Europe Championship. Unfortunately, there is no skip button, so it has to be done race by race. I'll be doing that offline, or more like while I'm not streaming. I'll start it later as well. For now, I'm done with Project Cars for this early afternoon. I would like to thank you all for watching. And I'll see you next time. There's a race, online race, official online race called Four Seasons. It's vintage touring cars Group B. So it's the old Mercedes, old BMW Sport. It's on the Scottish track. I forgot its name. It's quite a nice scenery. It will be happening during early morning hours in game. And it will be Four Seasons, so it'll be rain, dry, foggy, and snowy. 90 minutes long race. I think it happens at 8:30 GMT. Again, thank you all for watching, and see you next time.